Minds back to 1990, because that was the year the church last ever had a hit. It wasn't even much of a hit of that. I know you're dying to hear this one now. Okay, here we go. Thank you. Flop of a pop star called Eros Zitar, and he lives in the year 2054, and he's from a continent called Antarctica, and he hears about, he can't write songs anymore, and he hears about this thing, this machine, this event, this singularity that's pulling the songs straight out of people's minds, straight out of their past lives, music that perhaps should never be heard. Anyway, he decides to go and have a go. And after his first session, which is absolutely devastating, he stumbles back to his room and he writes this very song we're going to play for you right now. It's called The Hypnagogue.
Journey, the freaking flourish, but that's enough.
says, Eros, don't use the fucking hymn to God, man. It's crazy. Eros doesn't listen. He goes and does it anyway. Here then is the manager's message put into a song by us. Because the manager didn't have enough talent to write a song. So we had to do the imaginary manager, I should say. Didn't have enough. They're all quite imaginary, and they're quite imaginative too. Anyway, here is that song by the manager to Eros, telling him don't use that machine. And this song is called C'est la vie. vicious applause. Yeah, we do appreciate it, thank you. Alright, when the flaky, feckless flop of a pop star gets a career, he falls in love with a woman who invented the whole damn thing. She's a bit of an evil scientist, but she's beautiful too, as they always are, those evil scientists. And he stumbles back to his room and he writes this song of love for her, and it's called No Other You.
No other you.
seen.
Yes!
Close, try to slow. songs really have to say anything or be anything. This next song is just a song to come on the radio one day in the future, when our feckless, flaky, floppy pop star gets to Korea, he calls a cab and walks outside to get the cab. You can imagine the black sky with crimson stars, the firs and the pines and the spruces all viridian green, great white vanilla snowdrops falling out of the sky so softly. He climbs into the back of the cab, and it's warm and peaceful, and the driver leans forward, turns on the radio, and the cab is immediately flooded with the feeling of nostalgia and childhood comfort and beautiful days just out of reach of memory. And this song that comes on the radio is the song that we play now. It's called Flickering Lights. Yeah. floor. Hot nights in the cold, I caught you briefly. You were such a good sport, you said you wanted for me. my hesitation to the title surgeon. Jesus, gosh.
Down in the face.
Thank you, thank you. I'd also like to mention it's Rick from the Afghan Whig's birthday today. So happy birthday to you. Can I get some guitar? Happy birthday to you. Oh, they're hopeless, they can't even play fucking happy birthday. Anyway, happy birthday, Rick. Okay, I've got one more song for you. It's been what a wonderful, at the iconic, one of the most famous venues in the whole fucking world. If they had the remnant of the ancient wonders of the world, if they had the modern wonders of the rock world, surely First Avenue would be in it. Okay, we're going to give you this last song. It's been such a pleasure, obviously, being here on this beautiful, warm Minnesota night. We love all of you. Thank you for, if anybody who's been being a church fan all these years, we sincerely thank you.
Don't know why. It was clear and coming in hot.
No. Yeah, you do.
It's the clubs and the space.
And I'm gone.